And I will present very quickly some results together, which was done together with my postgraduate student Grigoriev, Spiridon Russo, and me. And this will be about influence of double feedback on stationary state of quantum dot lasers. And the outline of my talk, introduction, investigated setup, equations, numerical results, and conclusions. It is well known that semiconductor lasers have become indispensable in the modern society. In other words, everyday activity are unimaginable without personal computers, internet access, laser printers, displays, etc. And these all devices, they are operating on based on lasers, on semiconductor lasers. Semiconductor lasers are widely used in a variety of fields such as medicine, optical communication, chemical industry, CD, DVD, blue disc, mechanics and measurements, spectroscopy, display system, and so on. And it worth mentioning that semiconductor lasers are of interest not only due to the applications, but also in terms of fundamental research, since they form nonlinear system. This figure shows the device, our device, and it consists of active region, which is gallium nitride quantum dot lasers. And we have three, this represent active medius quantum dots and distant external resonator. This one. We have two phases, phi and psi, and such a laser was done for quantum world with active region quantum world in Pavia in Italy. Maybe they will switch soon to quantum dots. And we consider the structure shown in previous figure and the model of the quantum dot laser with an active medium using the follow system of Bloch equation, in which E is the amplitude of the field, P is the polarization, N is the inversion. And terms gamma 1 and gamma 2 describe the double feedback. I will not go into the detail on this formula, and only I tell that for quantum dot and active mediums, the parameter for the system have the follow values. Okay, these values have been collected from literature. And for further numerical analysis of the system of equation, it is more convenient to normalize the equation of the system to the lifetime of the caries, including the following new parameters. When I worked many years ago in the a group of academician Moskalenko, always he tell to me, okay, these equations are nice, any equations are nice, but first try to do some analysis. From analysis, you will see how physics is nice. And we got the final equations. Of course, it is much easier to include this equation in some standard programs and solve them in the stationary case. But together with my colleagues, we look for some analytical work. And we analyze the solution of the equation in the form of external cavity modes, with the following forms. This is for E, this is for polarization. There is some detuning between E and polarization. And for convenience, we use the following notations, which are more convenient for us. And we look for the stationary case just to get the stationary solution of the equations. We got some transcendental equations. Okay, they are somehow complicated, and but they can be solved. And we obtain one equation for external cavity mode, which is called omega s, which is a transcendental equation, and this equation can be solved. Also, we obtain analytically the amplitude value of laser field and a polarization vector. Yeah, and finally, we got an equation, cubic equation for carrier density ns. Yeah, and in this case, the system can be solved, and of course, with some numerics, and we study the distribution of mode. Usually, the distribution of modes was on the ellipse, but due to the presence of cubic equation, which is here, we got some another distribution here, and we observe that in this case, the distribution of modes is not anymore elliptic, but some kind another one, and then we increase the feedback strength, and you observe that there are some three ellipses which are deformed here. When we increase more the feedback strength, then the number of ellipses increases. And in the first case, we see a bell, which was present for the first time from our knowledge. Now, let's look when we change the feedback we can do by changing the reflectivity in first bar branch, in second branch, and we play with the parameters, and for a small increase of feedback strength in first branch to 10, then to bell appear two ellipses on the left side, on the right, then we have the distortion of this bell, and also a lot of ellipses which are present for feedback strengths of gamma, which is 15 in units, is 1 divided by nanoseconds. And when we increase the feedback strength in first branch to 15 and change in the second branch, then we have some strange figure here, and it shows an idea that, okay, only already for the stationary solution, the feedback strength influence the location of mode. When we increase more the feedback strengths, then we got the same as in previous case, some similar figures. And we got the information that for feedback, for increasing on feedback strengths for laser with quantum dot, we can get some chaotic behavior. Why we need this? We need for communication with the chaos. And this communication is with chaos, is more safety, and it was checked together with my colleagues from University of Palma de Mallorca and Greece in the metropolitan area of Athena. And finally, I came to the conclusion. We studied the stationary state of the laser with active medium quantum dot under the influence of optical feedback. For this, we use the model of Bloch equations, which help us to obtain expression for amplitude values of laser polarizations. These are analytical expression, and we also obtain a transcendent equation for determining the model of the outer cavity. We found the external cavity mode allocated on the shape of bell, and we believe the result presented in this paper is a good basis for future study. As I mentioned, we want to use such small devices, very small devices, for communication and communication with chaos. And I acknowledge the project which with this NAMBO, which is financed by Ministry of Education and Science, Education and Research, and ANICD. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Professor Vasile Tronciu, for your presentation. Some questions?
I have one.
Yeah.
Is there any dependencies on the environment temperatures?
Yes, of course, there are some dependencies on the environment temperature. But this one, for example, for our laser, it's important to have the same behavior even you are, for example, in Brazil or you are in Siberia. This means we have to look for the best property of laser and to keep the temperature constant. Other way, it will give you some, for example, you are looking for some chaotic behavior, but due to the temperature, it can happen that the laser, it's not anymore in the chaotic behavior, which you need for communication with chaos.
Thank you.